Windy City Poker Championship is produced by Follow Productions, Inc. and is owned by Windy City Poker Championship, Inc. For more information, call 708-935-2861.
And I tell you, the Poker Depot is a great company. They work really well for us here at Annie Up.
Almost back at even again.
They're our official store for all of our merchandise.
And that store is expanded throughout the South now. Blinds are up, 75-150. Dennis, pocket eights.
Snowmen. Seems only appropriate here in freezing Chicago. Thanks for hitting me with that snowball earlier today in the parking lot.
It was a defensive move. Raises to 400. Ryan's out of the way. Paul won't play.
It's four.
I think we'll call Ruben Uncle Tilty now.
Raise.
Nico, pocket aces. You gotta like that when there's an early position raise and a caller. You got some money in the pot.
First time we're seeing aces tonight.
1150 more.
Very confident. That should send some serious signals to our pro.
1150 more. Eights are a good hand to raise the first time. Tough to call after a big raise.
It's nice to see that the only thing that's changed with Dennis Phillips is he's got a nicer watch.
That is a pretty nice watch.
I think that thing picks up, like, Showtime on it.
Yeah, Ruben's got a hand that plays well with lots of opponents, but he's heads up now.
11.50 more.
I think we should get our producer to put some steam coming out of his ears. He wants to get those chips back in a hurry.
This is a great hand for breaking pocket aces, though. Oh, and he gets a piece of that flop.
I would say a big piece. A pair of eights plus a flush draw, a backdoor straight draw.
There's Nico with a set.
Goes check, check.
Now Nico's going to bet out on the turn.
2,000.
A quick call. He now has a straight draw to go with his flush draw and pair.
Million outs, and not one of them come, Chris.
Nico checks. That's interesting.
Well, wants to see whether Ruben's going to take a stab at this. The board is also a little coordinated there, too.
I think he's playing the player here. He knows that Ruben has a
four.
Penchant for betting.
4,000.
Player makes it four.
Re-raise. Make it 10.
Oh, boy.
Wow.
Ruben's just stepping in all the wrong spots today.
He picked the wrong time to be at the feature table.
Really tough to call the third pair here.
Pot's nearly 22,000 chips.
So it's 6,000 more to me?
That is correct.
Makes the call. More bad news for Ruben.
Six more, sir.
Tough hand.
Nice hand.
Nice pot for Nico.
When I was your age, I used to get aces all the time. I don't know what happened.
Nice tight shot on this great TV table we have for this event, Chris. Line still 75-150.
Flopping sets is pretty nice, though. Yeah, you know, I don't really know if
Ryan
there's
Folt,
any
6-9.
Book that says how not to play him.
Paul with ace 5.
I don't know. I'm trying to figure out the quads.
Oh, it's simple. I'll show you how it's done. Ready? This is how you
go
start.
Go for it.
First, you start off raising.
Okay.
We had 75-150. Okay, you 3x it.
Since I want to learn this, should I even look at my cards or just call you?
Sir, I'm here to help. So then you get called by Kirk.
Oh, see, now I got to look. I might have called him blind otherwise. Yeah, but now I got
to
look.
Quite a lesson here for Aaron.
It's easy to be relaxed and sarcastic when you're picking up pocket pairs and have all the chips at the table.
You get the most intimidating player in the hand to fold, so now your head's up. Now you have two options here. You can either flop quads or flop a set. I'm just going to flop a set.
Kirk has your favorite hand, Chris. Ace 10.
They call that hand the Cosenza.
I call it a loser.
I check.
Okay, so now you know that he hit the flop, so I'm going to have to fire out something here.
Make it small. 800, I call.
Our resident lumberjack makes a quick call.
I got this sinking feeling you got his hand he had a minute ago.
Oh, his hand?
Yeah, if you got aces, that'd be crazy. I check.
Why, do you got a boat already? It's kind of bad. All right.
Aaron is relentless, Chris. Relentless.
He has to be worried about the two overs to his cards, though.
I don't have quad sevens.
I know.
I lost track of how I'm trying to do that. I'm just trying to win this hand now.
Got a $1,300 bet in there.
I got this sinking feeling, though, that you got something big. Perfect timing. I really do. Is that 13?
Yes, sir.
Kirk, not willing to give up, does not believe Aaron.
It's tough. Aaron's playing so many pots, you can never put him on a hand.
And that's what makes a good player. Kirk makes the call. Ace on the river.
Not only does it hold up, it gets better. He's got three pair now, Chris.
As we all know in Texas Hold'em, you can only play your five best cards.
I don't like that rule.
31.
Five.
You've been 31?
Oh, I meant to make it 31. Oh.
The bet is actually...
Did you say 31?
No.
I bet the chips first.
Yeah,
I actually
just for the chips and the legal bet.
Accidental overbet for Aaron there. Well, happens to us all at some point. And the thing about these accidental overbets, it puts a lot of pressure on your opponent.
See, that river helped me though.
Yeah? You got a flush now? Now I have a question really quick. I bet out. Did I say what I
did not hear any bet from you.
I heard a 31, but I didn't know what it was.
Yeah, Kirk's just trying to get a cheap call here.
But that is your bet, sir.
He does not want to have to call this many chips, but can't get away from this hand.
Let's see. What could you
Can't blame him for trying, though.
Ace is up.
You got a straight.
You're good, Kirk. You're good, bro.
I don't know.
You are good. I just lost an extra 7K in that hand. Ship it to you. You had the best hand the whole time. Nice hand. That just cost me about 7K extra.
Because I heard 31. I didn't know when it was. You know?
I put the chips out first. I know I did.
I'll tell you, Chris, what I like about Aaron is he's a true professional here. Admits his mistake.
Hey, yeah, that's you make some big runs, though. You did that at the circuit event. I know you were down for a while, and what'd you get, second place?
Yeah.
Jack 4, you know, they call that the flat tire.
Why do they call it the flat tire, Chris?
Because what's a Jack 4?
Wow.
Final table, I hope.
Wow. All right, Aaron's out of the way.
What is it, 150?
Ruben's got a better Jack. Fancy nickname for Jack 10?
I call it the mistake.
All right, Bernard calls with ace 4.
You're telling me it's my last hand. Do
Nico
I play this?
Nico calls with ace deuce.
Yeah, sure.
Why not?
Yeah, baby.
Kirk can't fold now.
Check.
Ooh, I have position.
You folks at home, not with a widescreen TV, you're probably missing all the cards. Six players in.
Flop. Queen, jack, queen. Ruben finally hits a hand. They all check. Eight on the turn.
Wow. This will be a quick hand.
Wow. I haven't seen this many checks since I went to the Yvonne Lendl Fan Festival.
Rivers of four hearts, and Ruben is finally going to take a stab at this.
No one has any of this.
At least I pumped up the boss.
Bernard's fours. He knows to get out of the way.
Okay.
All right, gentlemen, it was good playing with you. Hopefully we'll see you at the final table.
Well, it looks like Kirk and Aaron will be leaving the featured table, but Bernard Lee will be sticking around, and our own Catherine Crane had a chance to catch up with him.
Hey, guys, I'm here with Bernard. Now, we won't make you give away any of your secrets, but any advice for the average Joe?
Yeah, I mean, I think the biggest advice that we give is don't play too many hands. I think the average person just plays way too many hands. They'll play hands that look good on paper, king, queen, queen, jack, king, jack, things like that. But those are the hands that just get you in trouble. And I think that's probably the best advice anyone can have. And the less hands you play, probably the longer you'll stay in the tournament.
Don't go anywhere, folks. After the break, Catherine chats with Richard Roper, who is playing in this Windy City Poker Championship.
Sorry, you're not going to get any straight answers from me. That's
all right. That's all right. We'll have a little fun.
Great.